The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
You gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you download and install it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now. Oh. Hey.
Roller skates and lights, hot sun and clear blue skies, the waves are crashing by. And when she passed me by and gave a wink and smile, and I was on cloud nine, love. The way you move your hips and lick your lips, the way you dip, you got me up so high. And girl, you got that body with them curls like a Bugatti, I just wanna drive. Oh, and girl, you know, round and round your love, it winds me up like a hula hula. Like a hula hula hoop, hula hula hoop, oh, oh, oh. Round and round you love. like a hula hula hoop, hula hula hoop.
This week I'm going to take you back quite a ways, back to the days before we had Facebook or before we had Twitter and we could tweet things about professional wrestling news or we could post things about professional wrestling news on our Facebook walls. I'm going to take you back to about 2004, 2005. We all remember MSN Messenger and how you could talk to wrestling fans about professional wrestling news through the instant messaging program. And I remember talking to a lot of wrestling fans about different stories that would be publicized on news websites from back in the day like ProWrestling.com or Figure Four Online. And I remember one conversation that I had through the MSN messaging service with a wrestling fan on how much wrestling news was actually posted on professional wrestling news websites. You would finish reading a news article about professional wrestling, about whatever the article was referring to, and then less than 25 through 30 minutes later, some new wrestling news would be publicized, and it was very difficult back in the day to keep up with all the wrestling news. And that could be more true in 2016 because we have so many news stories to cover, and on times it is very difficult as someone who has followed professional wrestling news for forever, over 17 years this coming August, talking about what I've done with professional wrestling. It is very difficult more so than ever because there is so much news in 2016 in comparison to 2006, a difference of 10 years. What a difference 10 years has made, because there's so much wrestling news in the way of injuries, debuts, firings, releases, so much to talk about. The wellness policy is in there too, factoring in with the drug tests and everything that takes place in professional wrestling. There is so much happening in the way of professional wrestling news, and on times it is very difficult to talk about everything you may like to talk about on your radio shows or for your written columns on your websites, whatever your role is with professional wrestling, and even more so, especially when you're meaning to talk about something, and then something is publicized within hours of you meaning to talk about something, and you have to change the course of your entire radio show or your written column and what you meant to write about or talk about on your radio show. And I had something to talk about this week. I was going to actually talk about Becky Lynch and Charlotte's feud for the Divas Revolution, but that was before I found out that John Cena is going to be missing WrestleMania this year because of a major injury, which will sideline him for a number of months. There have been photos and videos posted on professional wrestling news websites of John Cena's surgery. WWE released their own video footage and photos on WWE Monday Night Raw this past Monday, confirming that John Cena is out with a major injury, and that is a real bummer and letdown for John Cena fans, because I was really hoping that we were going to see John Cena be a headliner this year for WrestleMania 32, either in the way of an 8-man tag team match or a one-on-one match against Del Rio for the United States Championship. But now we have Kalisto changing the complexion of WWE as the new United States Champion, obviously changing the direction of the U.S. title division for WrestleMania this year, knowing that John Cena is not going to be there for WrestleMania this year. They had to do something to change it up and shake up the complexity of the U.S. title division, and they obviously did that with Kalisto, with John Cena giving him an opportunity, knowing that John Cena is going to be missing WrestleMania this year. Really appreciate what they're doing there, but I was really hoping we were going to get John Cena versus Del Rio in this year at WrestleMania, because I really thought that with how many wrestlers we had previously heard about being on the DL and missing a number of months of action, especially around this close to WrestleMania, with Randy Orton out, with Seth Rollins out, with Sting out with a neck injury, was really hoping John Cena was going to come through. And I just recently finished writing a column, just to give you an idea of how quickly professional wrestling news can change with detail. I just finished writing a column of John Cena's 2016 WWE return, something we've been waiting on to see since last October when he first lost the U.S. title to Del Rio. And I was so excited. Now I'm like, holy fuck, John Cena just came back and now he's out again.
with a major injury. So this obviously changes the direction of things like the U.S. title division for WrestleMania this year with everything we've seen derived from John Cena's injury and it being confirmed that he's missing WrestleMania with Kalisto now as your new United States champion. And obviously it will be that way for a while, at least until John Cena comes back. And probably what we'll see then is John Cena versus Kalisto. Not my choice of a U.S. championship match, given the U.S. title matches we've seen over the years. Everything from Sting versus Vader, it is a far cry from that. But that's probably what we're going to be seeing for John Cena, and it just really upsets me that he's going to be missing WrestleMania this year, because I thought that if Cena was not going to be U.S. champion for WrestleMania this year, he was somehow going to factor into everything happening with Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar, and we'd probably see a three-way between John Cena, Roman Reigns, and Brock Lesnar, with Reigns as your defending champion. And now we're seeing Triple H versus Roman Reigns, and possibly something like The Rock versus Brock Lesnar this year for WrestleMania, which pretty much has to happen. It's got to happen this year, because there's really nothing for WWE to offer us. The only thing that we can look forward to this year for WrestleMania, obviously, is, yes, The Undertaker's one match this year, which probably will happen because he doesn't like the fact that Sting is going in the Hall of Fame before him, and he'll have some sort of issue with that, resulting in him challenging Sting for a match this year at WrestleMania, which could be your main event, given everything that's happened and how they don't really have much to offer us this year for WrestleMania. Triple H versus Roman Reigns, and possibly something like Brock Lesnar versus The Rock factors in there as well. I was really hoping we were going to see a 4-on-4 tag team match this year for WrestleMania, with John Cena capping his own team, probably with the Usos and Chris Jericho, against the four members of the League of Nations, because I thought Cena was doing wonders for the League of Nations, especially Del Rio, who just came back from Mexico to WWE and just won the U.S. Championship. So obviously Cena keeping up with his purpose, serving it well by pushing new talented wrestlers and creating stars out of people, most recently Kalisto, who of course is suffering from how Sin Cara was injured, and they were in line for a tag team title push as the Lucha Dragons facing the New Day, which was something I was really looking forward to. Now, obviously, the New Day will face the Dudleys this year at WrestleMania, commemorating the 20th anniversary of the Dudleys for this year's WrestleMania. But so much has changed, and again, it all plays out with how John Cena had this unfortunate injury, which will